KLCS.
Celebrating excellence in classroom video production in the Los Angeles Unified School District. This is the 28th annual Video in the Classroom Awards. Your host is Sue Evelyn Gill.
First up, Van Alden Elementary, winner of 3 Vic trophies. The Marshmallow Challenge shows what happens when students are instructed to build the tallest structure using marshmallows and a few other items. A number from the musical South Pacific helps the Van Alden students and staff stay in shape. And what better reason to celebrate math than Pi Day?
Pi Day is a special day that scientists and mathematicians celebrate because March 14th could be called 3-14, and the beginning of pi is 3.14. I should also mention that it was Albert Einstein's birthday. Happy birthday, Albert. Pi Day is celebrated around the world in schools, universities, museums, and here at Van Alden, where our third graders did have their spelling bee for multiplication facts. The top students from each class competed,
100.
And they each won a pie for their family. We're going to present those now.
Some teachers are even willing to take a pie in the face to make learning more memorable. And he's lucky to have a principal who is supportive of video production as a learning tool. From Van Alden Elementary, let's meet Brad Upshaw.
So Brad, congratulations on your Vic Awards.
Thank you.
Tell me, in producing Go, 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 how long did it take to get the students ready to be filmed?
Well, the idea starts at the very beginning of the year, and we have to think, what are we going to film this year? And I don't really know. But this year, we had a directive that we were going to make sure that we were going to get our instructional minutes in physical education in. The district was being looked at to make sure we could do all of our PE minutes. And I thought, well, this is something we can really focus on. So I looked for a lot of opportunities to have physical education activities. And then I thought, we're having a lot of fun with this. Why don't we document some of this, have a video that other students could watch as a warm-up video. Hey, this is a great idea. And I remember when I was in fifth grade myself, and we would get up and work out to the Go You Chicken Fat Go song, and I thought, this could all come back together. Let's make a video that's focusing on physical education. And our students just started learning some exercises, and we used different locations around the campus, and we put together this short video, but a video that can be used over and over again, which is just a lot of fun.
Were you able to fulfill that and have other people on campus use this video?
That's right, and we got to show it to lots of audiences, including an open house, where a parent came in and said, oh, this is pretty good watching this. Hey, wait. Is this your class? They didn't even know. They thought it was something that we would just watch. They didn't realize their own children were in it, and they were really excited about seeing that. And we put it in and watch it whenever we need to, you know, especially when we're indoors. It's a place to exercise right there. It leads us as our warm-up to go out to do bigger physical activities. So.
Let me ask you about the Marshmallow Challenge. How did that prepare students for their Common Core assessments?
This is an amazing, fun project. And as it turns out, I did this with teachers at our buyback day. I had seen this on a TED Talk, and I thought, well, this is kind of fun, and we have to talk about a math this year, as I'm the math lead teacher. And I had to find some kind of professional development for teachers that would show teamwork, problem solving, and perseverance. Well, this was the perfect task for that. And we did that as a faculty back in August. And then I thought, well, this isn't just for adults. What if students had the opportunity to work in teams, to problem solve, to try lots of different things, and at the same time, you know, we could document that on videotape and learn from that. So that's what we did. We made our teams. We found out about the tallest buildings in the world as a side investigation, some research, and then we named our teams, and then we had a great activity. What was really great about it is it generates a lot of talk, and it's student talking to student, and that's something that we're really trying to get more about. Because we can just find one answer or ask one student at a time. But to have students come up with ideas, share ideas, and really explain their arguments is the idea. We got that with that project.
But then we noticed that the marshmallow was too heavy to put on the cross. So then we just like, we will try again.
This is right, because like if we didn't put this, it would like go like that and it would have fall down.
3, 2, 1, smile.
Brett, you've been doing this for so long, and you know, I consider you an expert now. What would you say to somebody watching who hasn't quite jumped in with both feet, but has been thinking about the idea of including video production in their classroom, particularly if they're an elementary or middle school teacher who isn't a dedicated media teacher?
I think the process of production covers a lot of areas. I think that if a teacher can find the time to figure out how to bring in all the curriculum and find a very interesting way to present it to the camera, that's worthwhile. It's very tricky with all the mandates and all the requirements and thinking about these amazing assessments to reach that Common Core goal. But I think that this is as an avenue that's worth trying. Plus, you are creating something that is lasting. And even if it's something that you don't show to anybody else, the process of production is very valuable. I think teachers should try to do it. Whether they have the skills or not, they're going to find out that their students have the skills. And all of us really love a good story. And as educators, we want to help our students become better storytellers. And video production is one way to do that, I think. They don't have much time in their day, but they can be very creative and very essential about what's necessary in their curriculum, and then put that together with media. And I think they'll be very happy that they did that. And so will the audiences that watch their productions.
Well, Brad, thank you for your time. And again, congratulations on your Vic Awards.
Thanks.
You're watching PBS SoCal, PBS for Greater Los Angeles.
California Student Media Festival.
The California Student Media Festival is the nation's oldest student media festival, and it exists to celebrate students and teachers and the amazing work that they're creating in their classrooms every day.
It's quite intimidating and fun and amazing to see how many other people and students were able to create films like we do.
The festival reaches out to students and teachers from all across the state through our relationships with partner school districts, through organizations that support technology in the classroom, and through the public broadcasting system.
You are great representatives of 49 years of work. Congratulations. So we started with an earthquake, and now what we want to do is make our own earthquake with our feet as we watch the winner in physical education from Van Alden Elementary.
Hey, run to roof like a tortoise. Okay, zoom on, and just slow. Now double up, ready. Run to three, four, run to three.
With 3 third graders from room 14. Also in the audience today, we have another faculty member, Mrs. Burns, and Ava, the star of the show, is out in the audience, and my ride home, Mrs. Upshaw, is here. These girls were already award winners. I'd like to introduce you to Christina, who won the Excellence Award, and this is Josie, who won the Character Award, and this is Juliana, who won the Principal's Honor Roll Award. And she went above and beyond. She won all the awards. Girls, would you like to thank the audience and Wells Fargo, please?
Thank you. Thank you for the award, and I had fun doing the video. Go, go, go. Okay, thank you for this award. It had a lot of teamwork, and it took a lot of work because like we did it like three places. We did it in the auditorium, we did it outside, and then we did it somewhere next to the trees. And we took a lot of time, and it was because of work. I just want to say thank you for this award and for thanking PBS and Wells Fargo. I just want to say we had a lot of teamwork in it, and it took a lot of time to make Giuseppe do this video. And his wife, I just want to thank you for this award.
During the 2015 California Student Media Festival, we received more than 400 entries, honoring about 60 projects this year. It's an exciting opportunity for kids to create and use technology to benefit filmmaking. What impresses me most when watching the films from the California Student Media Festival is how unique the different stories are that these filmmakers are telling. We're honoring students that are amazing talents, and some of them are the youngest of students that we work with. The awards for the California Student Media Festival are awarded to the best filmmakers within their category. We honor them at the festival today, and then moving forward, we continue to stay in touch with them with opportunities that might advance their filmmaking careers.
This award.
Thank you for the trophy.
Thank you for our big trophy. We were very happy.
Thank you for the big award.
Thank you for this award.
Thank you for the award.
Thank you, the judges, for the award, because our videos were really fun because there was marshmallows in it and there was exercise and it was really fun.
Thank you, the judges, for the award.
Thank you for the trophy.
Thank you, Vic Judges, for our award. It was really fun making it, and I like to thank Channel 58. I liked it when everybody was participating, and it was really fun making it.
Thanks again for watching our video.
Thank you for the Vic Awards. Our class is really happy to get this trophy for our hardworking videos.
Thank you.
Thank you for the award again, and I had so much fun doing the videos. And people should do videos because it's cool and it's fun.
people should make movies too because they're really fun, especially when it's exercise.
I like doing exercise because when I grow up, I can play different kinds of sports.
I like the parts to do the push-ups. It was so fun.
I like doing the exercise and the pro go sprint.
Part that I liked from Go 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 was the sit-ups, but they were also a little hard. And my embarrassing part was when I was running fast on the stage, and when it was open house and they showed the video, my mom was like, if we did the video, and I told her that it was, and then she's like, did your teacher take you guys out? And I'm like, yes. And then when it was about to be the embarrassing part, I covered my eyes on my mom's shirt.
My mom watched all the videos, and she mostly liked Go You Chicken Fat Go and the Marshmallow Challenge. And I hope I get it. I hope I'm on TV and I hope I get my sentence on camera.
I hope all my teachers in fourth grade and in fifth too do videos because it's fun to show other people how to do fun activities like these videos.
My family watched the whole videos about our movies and my family said that they were good.
Thank you for this award.
Thanks for the award, Vic Judges.
Thank you for this award.
Thanks for the award, Vic Judges.
Thank you for the award.
Thanks for the award. I really want to thank the Vic Judges for the awards that we got for these film videos.
Thank you, Channel 58, for our trophy.
Thanks for the big awards.